Song, and he showed me more complicated ways, so I'm gonna break it down for you guys. But I'm gonna also gonna put a little bit of music theory in the video. Let's get started. All right, I gotta break it down here. All right, so. For the first note, so actually in the beginning it's gonna go, so let's go, so we put B, C sharp, D, E, F sharp, and use your fifth for the F sharp, and then you go back down. C, you're gonna tuck in your thumb under your fourth finger, and when you're going to C, you tuck under it, and then you play D, and then D, and then F sharp. So it's Mary, Mary, did you know that your baby, oops, Mary, did you know that your baby boy was born on a creation? F sharp, D. So gonna scoot you down a little bit more so you can see my hands. So you're gonna play D, arch, D two times, then D, C sharp, B, A, and then G. You go over G, like I should, you go over. And then you play, for beginners I would say just play F sharp, but if you wanna go over, just play F sharp and B, so. Sleeping child, you're holding. So you put E. So it's E, F sharp, G, F sharp, E, B, E, F sharp, G. So and then when you're done with that, You're gonna play F sharp G, and then you're gonna repeat it again. You basically repeat it for three times, and then for your left hand, what you're gonna play a beat, an octave. An octave is when you play a note to another note, and you stretch. So that's the tool. So you're gonna play B octave, A octave, G. And then F sharp. Now, if you want, you can add an octave fifth. So you play F, B, and add an F sharp. Then you do the same. You move the position, but you never move the position that you're using. Now, we play when you play that F sharp, you play the B octave on your left hand. When you put B and then, so when you put the chord, you play A octave, G. And the only part that changes is when you do the high notes, you go. This is when the music theory comes. So when you play this, it's part of the D chord, because D, F sharp, A. It's more clear to do A, B, a D while doing it. So when you play A, you're gonna play C sharp. Yeah, you're gonna play C sharp octave. Then you can put B, because A, this is part of the A chord. B, when you play B, it's part of the B. And then you repeat. And at the end, when it goes, the blind will see, the dead will hear, the dead will live again, and lame will leave, the dog will speak, the praises of the Lamb. So that part is D. D down. It's C. D. C. C sharp. D. C sharp. And then. You do it again. And then you go back, reverse, and then you play A, A, B, and then you do it again. And then except going back like that, you go back, D, 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 G sharp. And that's when you play the F octave. You play the high alto. And have a keyboard, so you don't have to go back up. But you play B, D, C sharp. Yeah, then you do the thing again, the thing. And then when you go to. The thing I showed you at the end where you do the sleep and sound you're holding is the bed. You do it again. You hold F sharp, you do it rapidly, and then you go. And then you play A sharp, D, and then you just go. If you listen to the recording, it will be easier. To know, it'll make much more sense. So, on the left hand, we can play the. For this hand, for your left hand, alright, so for your left hand, you're gonna play. You're gonna play the F octave, so. And then you're gonna play faster. And then when you play the B, you play the B octave. So the only part that changes is when you play the G and then. You play D. Guys, I hope that helped you guys. And hey, and if you learned something new, please comment down below and tell me on down below what you want. And just to remember, this is my faith, kids. Thank you for watching. See you guys in the next piano vid. Bye. do, you know.